Hello, this is Mike Zamuda with Techytube.com, and today we'll take a brief look at the Foreach loop construct in C sharp and what actually goes on under the hood. So we'll just be looking at the resource pages from Microsoft, since we're more conceptual this time than writing code. So basically, what is Foreach? Well, it's a way of iterating over a collection that you basically put your program logic to apply to each individual object rather than having to worry about object indexes. And this can make doing operations that you need loops for very, very easy. And it's just kind of more intuitive to some people, myself included. So basically, you create any kind of collection you want. Now, that's any kind that implements enumerable. And we'll show you why in just a second here. But as long as your type implements that, then you can throw it in a Foreach. And the format is your type. So in this case, it's a primitive, so go int. A variable name you want to use, in this case, I. And you do in, that's always in there, that word. And the last parameter is the collection you are referencing. So in this case, it's our fib array, and that doesn't mean it's a false array. Obviously, this example is using the Fibonacci sequence of numbers. So once you get in there, you basically just treat that variable as your main object, and you put in your logic, and that will happen for every object in that collection. So this may seem useful to you. You might think, well, you know, it's okay. It's always good to have one more loop. But you might be asking yourself, well, why can't I just do this on any kind of object container that will contain more than one object? Why can't I just create my own class like that and go for it? Well, you can, but there is a reason that you need to implement enumerable. So this is not from Microsoft. This is actually an example on Code Project, but as you can see, it's from John Skeet, one of the Microsoft MVPs. So it's pretty reliable. So we'll just look at this right here. Basically, what happens when you use the Foreach construct is this kind of method obviously will be implemented by your collection class. So it actually creates a enumerator, and that's actually how it knows how to move to the next object, obviously, because there's the iterator object there doing what it does best, iterating. And you can also handle some errors here, or throw some exceptions that maybe should never be reached if your program is functioning properly, or even just a logging statement if you want to create a class like, I don't know, logging integers or anything like that. Now what this code sample does actually is pretty interesting. It actually treats the first element in this collection differently than the rest. So you can probably think of many situations you would want to do that in, and luckily it's made very easy with the Foreach construct and the underlying class using this interface, or implementing, I should say. So not too much more to say than that. I know quite a few people who don't use Foreach at all, and quite a few people who only use Foreach, depending on their situation. So it's just another tool in your toolbox. So thanks for listening, and we'll see you on the next video.